All right, we're using the Pioneer XDJ RX2. I'm also using Pioneer's software known as Rekordbox. Rekordbox will come free with the XDJ RX2. I highly recommend you put your files through the Rekordbox software to get the benefits and features of the RX2. In this video, I'm using a track by Dwayne W. Tyree, a track entitled It's Your Time to Party. It's from Karmic Power Records. There will be a link right down there in the description. I'm going to show you how to use or get the benefits of and what they do. The hot cue, the beat loop, also slip loop and beat jump. So let's play the track first. Here we go. Skip it forward a bit. Okay, so we're in beat loop mode. I'm now going to press the bottom right hand pad. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and press. Okay, so what I've done is I pressed bottom right hand pad, and what that's given me is a 2-bar loop. Have a listen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, every consecutive pad now I press next to the last one will reduce that loop by half. Next one is 1 bar. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1 beat. Half. Quarter. 18, 8, 16. Okay, there you go. Hot cues. Press a hot cue there, skip it forward, another one there, skip it forward, another one there, another one, another one, another one, another one, another one. Okay, I've recorded 8 hot cues. Now, if I press any of those pads now, it will go back to the place where I recorded it from. Very quickly here, something very important. When you're in quantize mode, let's imagine that you accidentally hit that hot cue just before or after the time you wanted it to snap in. If you're in quantize mode, the software will automatically snap it in time for you. On the other hand, let's imagine, you know, you want to set a hot cue, but you really want to tap it quickly, da 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 da, on the offbeat, on the accent of a beat, and you're finding it's not working. In other words, when you're pressing that hot cue, it doesn't seem to be doing what you want it to do. That is because you're in quantize mode. Disengage quantize, and then you can pretty much tap that hot cue as fast as you want, and the sound will correspond to your tapping. So, you see there? That's not snapping in my time signature. Disengage quantize, now have a listen. There, bang. Okay, so we've got 8 hot cues recorded. How do we get rid of those? I'm going to press shift, and while my finger is pressing on shift, I can now press those hot cues, and now we're good to go with another 8 hot cues, pretty much. Okay, so let's press play. Very quickly as well, another feature as well is about slip mode. So for example, with slip mode engaged, this is what happens. Let's set a hot cue. Okay, I'm just going to use 1, but this applies to all 8 again. Now that track is playing, I can press the hot cue. Now what's happening here is the track is jumping to that hot cue for that fraction of a second while my finger is on the hot cue. But as soon as I take my finger off, the track will go back to its original position as it was playing naturally. But the track will carry on playing as long as I want it to, based on the amount of time I've got my finger on that hot cue. Have a listen. Take my finger off and the track snaps to its original position. Disengage slip mode and now press the hot cue and it will now play from my hot cue. There you go. Okay, slip loop. All that's happening here is while I have my finger on any of the pads, again, previously, like the beat loop, I can have a certain amount of loop play while I've got my finger on that pad. Great as well with maybe a bit of filter. But again, all that's happening is it's now looping that part of the track. But as soon as I take my finger off, it will start, the track will carry on playing from the point where I take my finger off. On the other hand, if I want to keep the track in time, go to slip mode. Now have a listen. There. Now, using slip mode and using an effect like that is a very good idea, let's say if you're in a transition and you don't want that transition to change its place, change its position. So for example, you have got, say, a transition of, I don't know, 16 bars. If you don't use slip mode and use an effect like that, all that will happen is the track that you're mixing into the other one will lose its time signature with the track that's going out of the mix. On the other hand, with slip mode engaged, you can have some wicked effects and you will still have your 16 bar transition in perfect time from beginning to end. Okay, beat jump. This is a great feature because we now can jump one beat forward or one beat back. Two top left hand pads. The next two beats forward, two beats back. Bottom left, four. So again, we have from top right to top left. The first two is one beat forward, one beat back. Second two beats forward, two beats back. Bottom left, four forward, four back. And then bottom right, eight forward and eight back. Now again, in slip mode, the track will carry on playing as it would normally. Disengage slip mode, and then you're in the lap of the gods. That's where the skill comes in. Okay, I hope that's been a help. Excuse me. Check out the link in the description to Comet Power Records. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.